mathematicians, it's Justin again. Mia and I are back at the Miaville Art Museum, and we just stepped into a new gallery that features some stained glass. Some parts seem to repeat, like the same group of shapes showing up again and again. There's bound to be some math that's shaping this pattern. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain the difference between repeating and growing patterns, create and extend patterns using shapes and numbers, and identify the rule that makes a pattern predictable. Have your guided notes ready, and let's explore the math behind the masterpiece. When something repeats in a certain way or changes in a steady way, like the stained glass in the gallery, how can we describe what's happening? When a sequence of shapes, numbers, or designs follows a predictable rule, we call it a pattern. In math, patterns help us understand what's happening and figure out what comes next. Each number or shape in the pattern is called a term. A term follows the rule of the pattern and has a specific place in the sequence, like first, second, third, and so on. The rule is the specific way the pattern repeats or grows. It tells us what to do from one term to the next. So this pattern goes triangle, square, triangle, square, triangle, square. What do you think comes next? A triangle. This is a repeating pattern, which means it follows the same sequence over and over. To describe how a pattern repeats, we use letters. So this rule could be described as AB, because the same two shapes cycle again and again. Try creating a new repeating pattern with shapes that follow an AAB sequence. Think about what shapes you want to use, and make sure the first two terms are the same, and the third term is different, before the whole sequence starts again in the same AAB order. Pause here to create your pattern in your guided notes. No matter what shapes you chose, the key is the structure. Two of the same shape, followed by a different one, then repeat. As long as the order follows AAB, your pattern is spot on. But shapes aren't the only thing we can create a pattern with. We can also make patterns using numbers. Like this sequence, 10, 9, 9, 10, 9, 9. What do you notice about this pattern? We have one number, then two numbers that are the same, and then the pattern repeats. How can we describe this pattern with letters? This is an ABB repeating pattern. Try building your own repeating number pattern that follows an AABCD sequence, and record the first 8 terms for your pattern. Pause here to build the pattern in your guided notes. Here's what I did. 3, 3, 5, 7, 9, 3, 3, 5. The first 5 terms are that full AABCD sequence. Then it starts over, and the 8th term is 5 again. If your 8th term matches your 3rd term in your sequence, that means your pattern is repeating in the right order. The order is what matters, even if your numbers are different from mine. Nice job spotting the structure. Now, take a look at this pattern. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. Is it a repeating pattern? Nope. Not all patterns cycle back to the same terms. Some build over time, following a rule that keeps going in one direction. If a pattern doesn't repeat, but changes in a predictable way, it's called a growing pattern. A growing pattern will often increase in size, number, or complexity. Here's an example using polygons. It starts with a triangle, next is a square, then a pentagon, and a hexagon. What do you think the rule is? Each shape adds one more side than the one before it. That's the rule. Increase the number of sides by one each time. This is a growing pattern because it keeps building in a steady, predictable way. Pause here and draw the next two shapes in the pattern. How many sides will each one have? Record your thinking in your guided notes. If you drew a heptagon with 7 sides and then an octagon with 8 sides, then you followed the rule correctly. Of course, we can also make growing patterns using numbers. 2, 9, 16, 23, 30. What do you notice about how the numbers are changing? What could the rule be? Sometimes the rule can be described by using numbers and operations. For this example, 2 plus 7 equals 9, and 9 plus 7 equals 16. Each time we're adding 7, so the rule is add 7. Using this rule, what do you think the 10th term in the pattern will be? Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. When we add 7 each time, the 10th term in the pattern is 65. That steady increase is what makes this a growing pattern. Nice job using the rule to look ahead. Not all patterns are created by building on the previous number, though. Sometimes the rule is based on the term number or where the number falls in the sequence. Check out this table. What's the relationship between 1 and 8? 2 and 16? 3 and 24? Each time, the term is being multiplied by 8. So what would the matching value for the fourth term be? Well, 4 times 8 is 32, so 32 goes here. So the rule is to multiply the term number by 8. How could you figure out the 47th term's value? Pause here and record your thinking in your guided notes. Instead of listing every term from 1 to 46, we can use the rule to jump ahead. All we need to do is multiply 47 times 8, and that equals 376. Great job, mathematicians. Now that we've learned about repeating and growing patterns, we can figure out that stained glass art we saw earlier. What do you notice about its pattern? Part of the design repeats with the squares and circles, but the number of triangles is increasing each time they appear. So is this a repeating pattern or a growing pattern? At first, it might look like both. After all, the shapes appear in the same order each time, square, triangle, circle. But the number of triangles increases each time. Since that part isn't staying exactly the same, it's a growing pattern. Now it's your turn to become the artist. Create your own growing pattern using shapes or numbers. Just make sure your design grows in a predictable way and that you can explain the rule it follows. After creating your pattern, describe the rule of your pattern. Pause the video here to record your thinking. Your growing pattern should show a clear change that follows a rule. You might have a pattern that shows a shape increasing in size each time, or you could have created a number pattern where you add 10 each time, like this. As long as your design builds in a predictable pattern and you can explain your rule, you're right on track. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that even art follows the rules? Sometimes. Well, now you know that a rule tells you how a pattern grows or repeats. Repeating patterns follow the same steps again and again, while growing patterns build or change in a predictable way. And you know that a pattern can be extended by following the rule. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with patterns. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time. Hey.